Do you want to make your learning experiences more immersive with some background music? If you do, Storyline just came out with a new feature that makes it easier than ever to do just that. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use it. But I'm also going to show you a pretty big limitation of the feature and also what looks like a bug associated with it. Hi, my name is Scott Schmidt, and I recently joined Devlin's team. And over the last couple of months, I've helped dozens of instructional designers with Storyline. And I'm excited to share with you in this video how to use a brand new feature that's been highly requested for a long time. And that is continuous background music throughout your Storyline project. Now, up until now, this has only been able to be done with JavaScript, but now it's included directly within the program to make this even easier than ever. So let's go ahead and dive in and let me show you how you can use this feature in your Storyline projects. All right, let's take a look at how this works. All right, now first of all, step one is you got to make sure that your Storyline is updated because this new feature is only available in the latest update. Now to do that, you're going to want to open the Articulate 360 app, which you should already have because you need it in order to install Storyline. So when you open it up, when you see Storyline 360 here, if you look out here, it might say update. If it says update, go ahead and do that. If it doesn't, if it says open, then you should be all set. You probably have already updated. But again, make sure you're updated before you give this a try. All right, now I've created a very simple project here with three slides. And the first thing I want to do is just demo what this looks and sounds like. What you're going to notice is that when I flip between slides one and two, the background music plays continuously. It's as simple as that. So let's take a look. All right, background audio is playing. I'm going to go to the next slide. No pause, keeps playing. Previous, next. And it's as simple as that. That's basically what it does. Unfortunately, until now, you've had to use JavaScript to do something like that. And if you're not somebody who wants to try to learn code and all this stuff, you just want to have a feature built into Storyline to do something as simple as that, it's now here. Okay, so now let me show you how to set it up. Let's do it. We're going to go to the Insert tab, and we're going to go to Audio, Background Audio, and then you'll see this option here. Mine says Untitled Playlist because I've already created one. Yours might say new playlist or create playlist, something like that, but that's where you want to go. All right, now most of the features here are very self-explanatory in this window that popped up. Of course, you can give the playlist a name in case you have multiple playlists and you want to pick which one you want to use. You've got your list of tracks here. Notice that you can have more than one. Basically, they'll just play one after the other. You can have just one if you want, but you can have multiple tracks if you'd like. You can use the plus sign to add audio, probably from a file on your computer. You've got the trash can, so if I click on one, I could delete it with the trash can. I can also, with one of the tracks selected, I can move it up and down the list with the arrows. And the order does matter because it will play the first one and then the second one and then the third one and so on. All right. Now, down here, this is pretty self-explanatory too. You can make the tracks fade in and out, so it's more of a transition between them. And then, of course, we can loop the playlist so that if it plays through all three tracks, in my case, or however many you have, if it plays through all of them and the user is not done with the learning experience, it will start the playlist over again. So, very simple, very easy to understand. Let's take a look at these features, though. Because these features down here will allow you to kind of coordinate the background audio with other audio on the slide or video even. Let's look at the first option. Actually, let's look at the second option because we're not going to really take a closer look at that. It's very self-explanatory. It says pause background audio when video content on a slide plays. Very easy to understand. When video starts on the slide, the background audio will pause. Simple as that. When the video stops, the background audio will continue to play. So very easy there. But then we've got this feature that says lower background audio volume when slide audio plays. Now, what this means is that as soon as slide audio plays, and you might be wondering, well, what is slide audio? That would be any audio tracks that you have on a particular slide. A lot of times that would mean narration, or maybe a character is speaking and you have actual audio for that speaking part of the character. While that is playing, you can lower the background audio, but you can do it by a percentage. Now, I've got mine set at 0 right now, which means that when slide audio plays, the background audio will go away completely. 0% volume. Okay? That's what that means. Of course, you can increase it to whatever level you want. The higher the percentage you go, the louder the background music will be while the slide audio is playing. Okay, let me show you an example of how this works. All right, you'll notice on slide one, I've got these two buttons that say start slide audio and pause slide audio. So when I look at this slide, when I preview this, if I click start slide audio, I've got some narration there. The narration will start and the background audio will go to zero. Because remember, I set mine to 0%. So when audio plays on the slide, the background music goes to 0%. Let's take a look. Okay, background music's playing. That's normal. Now I'm going to start my narration.
This is sample slide audio.
Background audio went away.
Audio such as this can be used.
I'm going to pause the narration.
Or to bring.
Background music starts up again. Start the narration.
Characters to life.
No background.
It can be especially helpful.
Pause the narration. When the background starts again. So there, you can see how that feature works. It's pretty handy to be able to let the slide audio kind of coordinate with the background audio so they don't compete. Okay, so now, unfortunately, it's time to get to the bad stuff, and that's the limitation that I mentioned at the top of the video, as well as the bug. Let's start with the limitation. Unfortunately, right now, the only way to allow a user to control whether or not the background audio plays is through the player. If you're like me and you don't like to use the player in your projects, this is going to be kind of a bummer. You might want to reconsider whether you want to use it altogether. Okay? But let me show you where to locate that. Now, I didn't tell you it's in the player. So we have to enable the player and we have to make sure part of the player is enabled. I'm going to go to the Home tab, Player. And it's going to be down here under player controls. And it's actually under accessibility controls. Over here, I've got an example. It's going to be under the gear icon. So when people click the gear, they'll see a background audio toggle. And that's how they can turn it on and off. Let me quick show you in action.
Background audio is playing. I'm going to come down to the gear. Background audio.
And just simply click that toggle. I'll turn it back on
and off.
And there it is. So again, unfortunately, now if you like to use the player in your projects, then this shouldn't be an issue. But if you're one that typically doesn't use the player, this may make you reconsider using it because there would be no way for the user to turn it on and off if they don't want it, other than just muting their computer audio. But then if you have slide audio, they won't hear that either. So something to keep in mind. All right, now let's get to this bug. Here's what the bug does. The problem is that let's say I'm on slide two and I start my slide audio, so that narration. If that narration is playing when I click to go to the next slide, then when I go to the next slide and start my audio, the slide audio, the background audio doesn't stop. It doesn't go down to 0%. It keeps going. So you hear the background audio and the slide audio at the same time. Very distracting. It completely ignores that rule that we set up. Remember, insert, audio, background, right here. I set it to go down to 0% volume when the slide audio plays. But with this bug, it doesn't actually do that. The key is, though, this only happens if you go to the next slide while slide audio is currently playing. That's when it breaks down. Let's take a look at it in action.
Okay, slide one, no problem. I'll go to the next slide. Great, everything is fine. But now I'm going to start my slide audio.
This is sample slide audio.
And now I'm going to go to the next slide while this audio is playing.
Narration or to bring character.
Background music plays, but look what happens when I start my slide audio on slide three.
This is sample slide audio.
They're both playing. The background audio and the slide audio are playing at the same time, and it's very annoying.
It can be especially helpful and entertaining.
And look, if I go back and start the slide audio here,
this is
still broken. Once it's broken for good.
Okay. So that's a pretty big bug in my opinion, because it means that if you have narration on multiple slides, if a user did go to another slide while slide audio is playing, it's going to break and they will never be able to get out of this situation where the background audio and the slide audio both play at the same time. So definitely something to keep in mind if you're thinking about using this feature. So there you have it. You can see that this feature is extremely easy to use, but just keep in mind that big limitation with how the user can control whether or not the background music is playing. And if you're one that's going to use slide level audio, like narration, for example, you may also want to reconsider because of that bug that I just showed you. Now, if you are learning Storyline because you want to become an instructional designer, make sure you grab the Becoming an ID checklist in the video description. Okay, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.